So if you're looking to insulate or re-insulate your attic, you're probably wondering, do I need to ventilate the attic? How do I ventilate it with whatever insulation I put in there? Let's talk about it. Generally speaking, there are two schools of thought when it comes to ventilating your attic. The first is if you have your insulation on the roof deck of your attic space. Typically, this is where you see spray foam installed on the underside of the roof deck, sometimes known as a hot roof or a ventless attic system. Now, they call it a ventless attic system because in this application, you do not need ventilation. You do not need anything in the soffit, gables, or ridge vent. If you are putting insulation on the roof deck of your house with spray foam, this does, as I said, create a ventless attic system. So if you have spray foam on the underside of the roof deck of your home, you do not need to put ventilation inside your attic. The second method, if you have insulation on the floor of your attic, whether it's spray foam, fiberglass, or cellulose, you will definitely need ventilation in your attic space. The most common is a ridge vent running along the entire ridge of your attic space, and then open soffit vents with baffles allowing air to come up through those soffit vents and to get out of the ridge vent. You will also see sometimes gable vents, an open vent on either wall or both walls of your gable ends. This is also something to keep in mind. If you do need ventilation because you have insulation on the floor of your attic, you do see sometimes where someone put in a mechanical vent, so basically a fan on either one of the gable walls or on the roof deck itself. This is an option, but just keep in mind you want to make sure that the vent is sized or powered correctly to the size of your home and how much airflow you need to get through. You want to obviously consult an HVAC contractor if you want to put in a powered vent in your attic space. Now, obviously, it is crucial to get your ventilation correct depending on how your attic is set up. Now, again, these are the most typical generic types of attic ventilation. If you have something really specific or a custom-built roof or something that's a little crazy, again, you might need a hybrid of these situations, but these are the general rules. Here at Retrofoam, we do specialize on insulating existing exterior walls. However, on our learning center, on our website, we cover a ton of information, obviously, like attic insulation and everything building science related. So do yourself a favor, check out the link in our description below, go to our learning center and learn more today. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.